to Oxford Street, and it's overlooked by this rather iconic landmark of Roosevelt and Winston Churchill. It was commissioned by the Bond Street Association for the City of Westminster to commemorate 50 years of peace since World War II.
Proceeding directly to Burlington Arcade without passing go is Britain's first shopping arcade. It opened in 1819 and is still the longest covered shopping street in Britain. And guarding the entire arcade is a private police force, the Beadles.
How many times have someone come up to you and said, "Watch out, there's a Beadle about"?
If I had a pound, I'd retire.
Well, tell me about these gates, because they're big, they're bold, aren't they really necessary?
The story behind the gates is that in 1964, we had probably one of the first ram raids in England. A Mark II Jaguar came in, mounted the steps, drove into the front of a shop. About £35,000 worth of jewellery was stolen, which in 64 was a lot of money. At the time, they put bollards in. But since then, about 18 months ago, the new owners of the arcade, as part of the revamp, these gates were put in. They're more pleasant upon the eye, and also they do add extra security to the arcade.
And with the security come some rather bizarre traditions.
We have some rules which we still enforce, yes, from the Regency laws.
Like what?
You're not supposed to hurry in the arcade. You're not supposed to whistle in the arcade. Well, in fact, there's one person who is allowed to whistle, and that's Paul McCartney.
Why him?
One of my predecessors walked along behind him once, tapped him on the shoulder and told him, "You're not allowed to whistle, sir." And when he turned around, he saw who it was. Ever since then, we've made an exception.